Welcome to the September 2016 SpudShot. I'm your host, Newbiespud. Joining me is Avis Echo. Chrono Zephyr.
Hello.
Digo Dragon.
Yo.
And His Royal Highness Princess Zenkarn, Lord of Bombies, Duke of Death.
Hey, guys. And gals.
Or known as Cuteless, or he seems to be going by Zenkarn now. We were going to have a fifth player, but Oblivious had a bow out due to medical issues. I hope he gets better soon. Starting this month, and once every month going forward, I'm doing a one-shot campaign, which all of my Patreon patrons can apply to. The idea is to try out new systems and new ideas that I might not be able to fit into my next main campaign. This month, this one-shot is called Fallout is Dragons, Who Monitors the Monitor? Terribly original, I know. To sort of set things up, we return to the Dragon's Maw, the bombed-out remains of the southern Badlands of Equestria, where the dragons once secured their foothold. It's been 5 weeks since the Dragon Maulers prevented a dragon-based apocalypse, successfully bringing the dead dragons back into the world as Astaroth planned, but without unleashing their fury on the land. The Maulers have mostly disbanded to pursue their own goals and or get back to their own lives, depending, and the Maw has returned to a tentative sort of peace. But war never changes, yada yada yada. So 5 weeks after all that, Slayer Base, HQ for the local Applejack's Rangers, has a problem. Monitor, the AI Javolt inadvertently created, is growing too large for their meager servers. Ormar, at Stable 998, has offered to let her move in as a short-term measure. But to do that, they'll need to physically transport her data, and the Rangers are spread thin, keeping the peace. To that end, they're hiring a few mercenaries to play bodyguards, taking the risk that one or all of them might be hiding a dark secret. So we begin at Slayer Base in the northwest part of the Maw, the mostly underground bunker where the Steel Rangers, or Applejack's Rangers in this case, make their base, their HQ in the Dragon's Maw. All four of you have been called in, or rather answered the call, for a mercenary bodyguarding position. And you're all basically have been led down into this waiting room near the elders' offices. And one by one, you are called in. So as you're called in, I would like you guys to sort of introduce yourself, what you look like, you know, the basic gist of who you're playing today. First up is Nocturne, played by Ava Seko.
Of course I go first. Beautiful.
So who is Nocturne?
Nocturne is a dark, almost navy blue Pegasus with like faded blue and purple mane.
Mm-hmm.
And
what does she do for a living in the equestrian wasteland? What are her
skills? She's essentially a thief for hire. She prides herself in making sure she remains unseen, being able to go into locations and bringing out whatever she desires as quickly as fast possible.
All right. So you are called into Elder Moonlight's office, and he asks you to sort of stand before the rounded, Steel Ranger's Elder's desk, and he says, "Can I trust you with a bodyguard position without worrying that you'll steal sensitive equipment?" He asks Nocturne this specifically.
Well, you can't trust many people in the wasteland with much of anything, but you can trust me with this.
Mm.
If I wanted to steal it, I would have done so already.
It's a fairly heavy piece of machinery.
I have my ways.
I'm sure. I wish we had more of a choice. So I'm willing to pay you 500 caps now, and Vault 998 will pay you another 500 caps on your arrival. Is that acceptable?
Of course.
All right. Head back out and call in a crash cart.
Okay. She leaves the room and calls crash cart in.
Ooh. We'll trot on in.
All right. So what does crash cart look like?
Crash is a slim Pegasus. Dark gray coat with a short crimson mane, wearing a slightly buffed, as in scratched, light bit of armor that has the Ministry of Peace logo painted on.
All right. You walk up to the desk and stand at attention more or less, and Moonlight asks, "So you're a medic?"
That's right. Traveling field medic.
How skilled would you say you are?
A scale of 1 to 10, I would go with a 9.
That's pretty good.
Full confidence.
What made you want to be a medic? What circumstances led you to being a medic?
Just watching too many people get sick, injured, and dying out in the wastes. Right. Just can't really stand aside and just let it continue to happen.
So you put a lot of value in other ponies' lives, even if they could be your enemy tomorrow?
I certainly do.
That's good. That's very good. All right. Head out and call in Crimson Sky.
Yes, sir. All right. So, well, door with a wing and say, "Crimson, you're up."
Crimson will nonchalantly walk in.
All right. What does Crimson Sky look like? What does he do?
She.
She. Right. Sorry.
Crimson Sky is a crimson Pegasus with a dark brown mane. Is going around wearing a duster coat of reasonable proportions. Not one of those that drag around on the floor. Well worn. And that's all there really is to show.
All right.
Crimson Sky, owner of Jackknife's independent mercenary company. Make up your own witty tagline.
All right, so he's got some notoriety to him. Moonlight looks at Crimson and says, "What kind of jobs has your company worked on?"
We've worked on being bodyguards, transportation, information carriers.
All right. What would you say your success rate is?
Well, aside for the one incident involving a crocodile, I'd say about 90%.
That's very optimistic. Have you been in business long?
About a couple of years by now. People have come and gone from the company, but it's a way to make a living.
Hmm. How do you treat or view your employees?
I treat them as if they're all my family, sir. Everyone deserves to be treated equally, especially in this harsh time.
Hmm. What happened to make you think like that?
Slavery, sir.
Ah. Very well, then. Say no more. All right. Send in Razor Pillow.
Crimson will flutter out and go, "Pillow, your turn."
Yes, sir. And I'll wander in.
So what does Razor Pillow look like?
So, actually, not a Pegasus, surprise, surprise.
Yeah. Three Pegasus.
So Razor Pillow is like a sort of dirty white unicorn. Sandy colored mane and tail, both cropped short, mostly for like making sure no one can grab it during combat, that type of thing.
All right.
Do you want cutie marks as well?
Sure.
Cool. So, yeah, and a cutie mark of an open shaving razor over a pillowcase.
As expected. So, Moonlight looks at you, quirking an eyebrow, and says, "So what skills do you bring to this operation?"
My legitimate skills, my not-so-legitimate skills.
Either. It's the Wasteland.
I was a guard for Ribcage for a while. Before that, worked in some of the Four Horses gang as a... I was going to say cleanup guy, but I was an assassin.
Mm-hmm. Is your intention to use those skills to help protect this cargo?
That's what you're paying me for.
500 now, 500 on arrival at Vault 998. Is that acceptable?
Better than most of the offers I've been getting lately, so heck yeah.
Very well. Give me a moment to deliberate. And he
can do.
Sends you out of the room. A few minutes later, you are all escorted, the four of you, to a meeting room, a briefing room. Moonlight is there, and on the table between you, there is a map of the Dragon's Maw on the sort of computerish display on the table. He says, "Congratulations, all four of you are hired." He levitates up four bags of caps and distributes them to each of you. There's your payment, and I will explain the finer details of this job. So, this is some very sensitive material I need you to transport across the Maw. And in order to impress upon you how important, I think it's only fair that you know, this is, in essence, an artificial intelligence. One that was critical in the war against the cult of Tiamat a month ago.
Oh, phew.
It's a smart robot?
I was kind of worried there, because when you said critical, I was hoping it wasn't going to be something explosive. Do go on.
It won't explode. It's the physical matter of what you'll be carrying are the server banks upon which Monitor is stored. But she does not have a robot body, nor could the vast amounts of data really fit onto anything smaller.
How large a cargo are we talking?
One or two of you might have to actually pull it along. You will have a sort of cart set up, heavily armored to protect the sensitive computer equipment, and locked, of course, so that no one can tamper with it.
We talking one box, two boxes?
One large box.
Sounds like it's pretty heavy.
The cart's somewhat powered, so it won't be too much trouble to pull it, but it will need to be pulled by some pony.
Colin dibs on not that.
It's not that.
Aunt dibs.
Well, don't crash the cart, I suppose. Anyway, he points on the northwest part of the map. We are here, and the destination, he points at the sort of south by southwest part of the map. Destination's here. That's Vault 998. Basically, the best path is to take the road that rings around the dormant volcano in the center of the Maw. We don't expect currently any specific threats, but we're also not entirely sure that the communication channels we used to set this up were secure. So, and of course, this type of cargo, if anyone knows about it, is very either valuable or blasphemous, depending on who you ask in the wasteland. So, I need strong ponies to guard it and make sure it gets to Vault 998 safely and intact. Monitor will be basically defenseless. I would send one of my own rangers with you, but unfortunately he was injured earlier, so we are spread pretty thin. If I had a choice, I wouldn't be hiring mercenaries at all, but...
Well, you've hired Jack Nice Independent Mercenary Company, so you got the next best thing.
Sure. Very well, those are basically the details. The journey should take you about 3 or 4 hours to complete, accounting for, you know, having to take it somewhat slow with the speed of carrying the cargo. And if you get in a fight, you are free to, unless they're clearly civilians of, you know, Skyfall or Ribcage or any of the towns under our protection, you're basically free to use however much force you like.
Don't worry, they won't feel it.
That's comforting. All right.
Would it sound more comforting coming from me?
I'm going to go with no.
We'll do what we have to do when the encounter arrives. If it arrives.
The Maw is less cursed and more peaceful than it's been in the past, but I still wouldn't put anything past the wasteland.
The Maw is as unpredictable as it has always been. We'll do our absolute best.
Very well. So, the rangers lead you to a massive service elevator where you finally get to see the cart, or such as it is. It's basically a kind of a contained piece of... It's built out of pieces of the bunker, it looks like. It's this very heavily armored chassis of sorts. With on the back, there is a door with a wheel to open it that looks currently locked. With a very heavy steel lock.
Damn!
And there is, a hitch for a pony to carry it from the front. And four very sturdy-looking wheels. And you all step onto the surface elevator, and with a few barked orders, it clangs into motion and starts to rise. The ceiling above you opens up to reveal the harsh wasteland sky. And you all rise up to the middle of the above ground ranger's camp. Moonlight salutes you and says, "Best of luck. If we don't hear from you at Vault 998 in 4 hours, we'll be sending out squads to check on you."
You're sure it's in there, right?
He walks around to the back, uses a key to unlock the bunker compartment, and twists the wheel of the door open and swings it out. And inside you can see these blinking racks of servers, all connected to what looks like a temporary power source.
Neat.
Okay. No wonder we need the cart. This would have been hard otherwise.
Very.
Exactly. Now you know this isn't some kind of con we're pulling on you.
By the looks of things, it's
can't
still
hurt
active.
The tech.
So if it's still active, I'm assuming it's recording all the information that's being processed and whatever's going on within monitor along the way.
Sorry, repeat that?
By the looks of things, monitor's still active, so I'm imagining her processors are still picking up what's going on around her and recording the information as we make our journey.
Monitor doesn't have there aren't terribly many sensors attached to this. It's mostly just her data and processes. Most of them are dormant, though. She's mostly in standby.
Sleep in beauty.
Essentially. So,
if any of this gets damaged, then
parts of Monitor's brain, it would be like you're chipping that away. So do not let anything damage this.
Right.
Noted.
Loud and clear.
All right. We all understand?
Clearly.
So, yes, sir.
All right.
Looking at the computer in the box, what does it have for ventilation?
It looks like there's a power source and a cooling system inside the bunker, but other than that, there's some very thin slit vents that you can't even tell where they lead out.
Bad if 3.5 hours later we deliver a pizza.
Moonlight goes, "What's a pizza?"
Forgive me for asking, but aside from the entire box being on separate encounters with you guys before, are there any other precautions added onto this?
Precautions? What do you mean?
Well, I mean, let's say if the four of us fall, they try breaking in.
If the car gets excessively damaged, there are a few emergency sensors, and we can dispatch a squad either from Skyfall or Slayer Base, or depending on where you are, maybe even the Vault. There are many, many interested parties that want to see Monitor arrive safely. But again, this is a risk, and we're trying to keep it, somewhat covert. We just don't have the resources to do this any other way, and it has to be done now.
Crimson nods. Just want to make sure.
Turn to the rest of the group, getting a sort of a sideways glance to the chariot cart thing. Who's riding with the cargo then?
I'll give first watch.
Sounds like a plan.
What do you mean riding with the cargo?
Well, someone's gonna be actually with the box, right? I mean...
No, you're all gonna stay outside. And he starts to close the door.
That sounds fairly tactically unsound. Lost line of defense and all that.
If something trouble happens, you're stuck in a box.
True, but on the other hand, if you open the box, who's going to expect, being stabbed in the face? They think
exactly.
That's the last line of defense. You stab, open box, stab face. Repeat action until they're dead.
He has a point, but it doesn't really look all that cozy in there, to be honest.
There's not actually a whole lot of room in there for a pony to sit comfortably.
I shrug, I activate miniaturize, and I shrink.
if it's the four of us taking, let's say, hourly shifts, at most, it's nothing really.
What's 3.5?
Yes, but that would mean that we'd have to stop every hour, open the cart, get the other person out, put someone else in, and that takes time.
It'd also take just as much time of pulling a heavy thing for 4 hours with no breaks. Take the time to rotate, to have a quick break, catch your breath, hydrate, and make sure we're all okay.
Got a point.
I don't know.
He's got a point, says the miniaturized unicorn assassin.
I'm adorable.
Moonlight shoos you away from the door and shuts it and locks it. And he says, out of the question, I'm hiring you to transport this cargo, not be in contact with it.
I'm going to agree with that. I'm going to agree. It's just because I also have to be...
It's not even worth pointing out that contradiction anyway.
Well, if I'm the one pulling it, my vote should weigh a little bit more.
Well, we can always switch, but not everyone is as strong as everyone else, so we might slow down anyway.
I'll return to normal size. Got a point there. We're going to need someone on extended pulling duty.
Right, how about this? Two who, well, Nocturne and Newcrash, you start pulling it first. After a while, whichever one's the weaker of you two, we swap out with whoever you want to choose first. After the next period of time, the other person swaps out. Keep working like that.
And then we continue swapping around until we're there?
Yeah.
As long as everyone gets an equal share, more or less, of pulling this thing, I'm fine.
I'll agree.
Why not? Gonna get paid either way.
All right. Moonlight nods and says, well, don't have all day, so best of luck. And he salutes and heads towards the main entrance to the base, allowing you guys to get hitched up and start your journey.
Alrighty.
On the road again. You know, right. I actually could have waited to go back on the road again.
Do they even have roads?
Yeah, there
sometimes.
Are.
Sometimes. Depends on where you are.
There are very well-worn, basically roads. Not a whole lot in the mod, but there is one that kind of goes around the mountain. So you make your way along the road down from Slayer Base, making pretty good time. As soon as the base is out of sight, though, you see in the distance approaching very quickly, in fact, what looks like a group of raiders with guns.
Of course.
Uh-oh.
God. They told me they'll go into clans and stuff now.
These don't look like Four Horses tribals. These look like just kind of garden variety raiders. And as they get closer, you notice that even there's like, you know, a half dozen of them, they don't look too confident either. They have guns, but the way they point them at you is not terribly confident. And the
And the
forwardmost raider, I guess, must be the leader because he's the one talking. He says, just stay where you are or we'll shoot.
Not
can't
carry
that. Sorry, guys. Kind of got a you job to do.
And I'm like, last thing you ever do, I was going to pull that gun where it doesn't shine from the little boy. Now get out the way. And Crimson Sky is just going to sort of cock her pistol. Move.
Gotta love the two completely different diplomatic approaches there.
Diplomatic.
Hey, I tried to be nice. That's the change for me.
You being nice, that's crazy.
I'm sorry, I won't do it again.
All right. Let me roll a thing in response to that super argument. And he manages not to piss himself. And he you know, looks to his buddies, which still seem to be backing him up, and says, if you shoot, then everyone else will shoot, and some of you will probably die?
You'll die harder.
Not before I wipe the floor with your corpse. Move.
Guys? But some of his buddies are already starting to back up. Okay, guys!
Looks like all your friends are leaving. I think you should too.
You should definitely follow them.
He slowly backs away and says, okay, we don't have to, you know, we can just talk this out, you know, I guess. And then just bolts and runs.
Thank you, have a nice day.
Dragging the barrel of his gun in the desert.
Nocturne just waves goodbye.
Raiders, not what they used to be back in my day, I'll tell you that.
Some of these are turning out to be very, what's the word? Wimpy?
That crap.
That's not my words, but yours.
Shall we carry the same. On then?
Yeah, let's carry us on.
He needs a name.
Gregory.
Gregory the Raider.
But he didn't die.
Yet.
Exactly, he's the one guy we save.
So then he can't be Gregory. His name is Pete.
I was thinking something. Did he have a cutie mark?
It was covered up by Raider armor.
Salty dishes.
No. No.
Alright.
Okay.
I just realized I labeled the year wrong on all the SpudShot stuff.
Nah, it's fine.
Anyway.
I'm totally fine with it being 2015.
You know, it would be so much better. It would be... Well, 2015 wasn't a great year for me either, if we're being honest. Anyway.
Onwards.
Onwards, then.
Upwards.
So, you keep going down the hill. A big shadow passes overhead. And you look up and you see a big green dragon just kind of flying in circles over the maw. Doesn't seem to be doing anything else. Just it's a big green dragon.
Just being a dragon. Even a dragon needs exercise.
Yep, it's just being a dragon.
Is there any kind of pattern to its movement, or is it just doing circles?
It's just doing circles around the whole maw.
Is there by any chance we can tell which dragon this is, with its local and once from before? Or...
You wouldn't know any dragons, personally. They haven't been the most sociable of creatures with ponies.
Out of character, I have a plan. We capture the dragon, we make it eat Poulakot.
I would like this plan, but I'm not fighting a dragon.
So it's not doing anything to harm us? It's just being there?
No, it's just being there.
Alright, may as well just ignore it and move on then.
Yes, let's go.
One does not simply ignore a dragon beam.
You can ignore it until it starts breathing fire, which it's not, so let's count ourselves lucky.
It's breathing fire
right now.
Into the sky, not down at
but
the ground.
But not at us.
Yeah.
As long as it's not circling us and not breathing fire at us, let's just keep going before it decides to do that.
Very well.
Primden is still going to wave in the general direction and go, bye, dragon person, and kind of float on by. He's not always menacing and evil.
Not so loud.
Alright, so your journey continues, and after a total of about 15 minutes since you left Slayer Base, you reach finally the junction leading to the ring road around the Maw, and there you hear a loud sort of crack, and then one of the wheels on the cart collapses.
Fish sticks.
The whole chassis tips over, and there's this loud bang from inside.
Ooh, that got me good.
No.
I'm gonna go on a limb here and assume they didn't bother giving us any spare equipment.
Sweet Celestia.
No, they didn't. There doesn't seem to be a spare wheel for this thing. Do any of you have utility talents that might be able to mend such a thing? Or is just good at repair?
Well,
we can do it to people, I can't.
Well, what would repair be?
To repair things.
What would you use to repair things?
Dex?
General knowledge?
Yeah, I'd say...
Totally heal.
Heal the cart. Let's go.
I'd say if it's kind of a tools thing, so probably a bit of dexterity. Maybe a bit of either general knowledge or perception to identify the problem and how to fix it. So if y'all could, if you want to take a look at the damage, at least on the outside, you can roll perception or general knowledge.
I'll roll general knowledge.
I'm going to roll...
Oh, Jesus, that was low.
I'm going to roll perception, because that's the bigger of the two for me.
Ow!
I'm so upset.
Not rolling the highest. Except for...
Give me one sec.
Wow.
Alright, so... Crash Cart, you unhitch yourself and take a look at the damage, and you notice that you can't seem to see. It looks like the wheel kind of broke, but it's like you can't seem to see where the missing part might be. And on further inspection, even closer inspection, it looks like the wheel didn't just like break or shear off. It looked like it kind of dissolved a bit.
Oh, geez.
Oh.
Is there anything in our immediate surrounding that could, I don't know, be used to help, unless we have stuff on us?
Well, nearby there seems to be a ruined building. But, about a minute into your investigations, you hear a, like a little filly's voice running towards you.
Slow down there, little one. What's going on?
It's a little, purple earth pony filly with wearing of all things braces and with like sparkles all around her eyes or something, like she's bedazzled herself.
I want three.
Oh god.
kill it with fire. I know where this goes.
Where's that dragon?
She's crying and looking back over her shoulder and saying, they're trying to kill me.
Okay, slow down. Who's trying to kill you?
She points off into the distance. Them! And you hear a sort of thundering of hooves, but also amidst them sort of clanking sounds, and you look off into the distance and you notice there seem to be some metallic pony-like creatures coming towards you. And then a beam of energy whizzes by Razor Pillow's ear. It seems like they've...
This is why I hate kids.
Seems like they've got laser weapons.
Remind me which fuckwits thought bringing guns back here was a good fucking idea.
Okay, well...
Right, as soon as they're within hearing distance... Now listen here, you son of a... I'm using soothing voice.
Sure. That's definitely soothing.
10 out of 10 would soothing again.
Oh my god.
Okay, what do you say in your soothing voice?
Right then, could you please stop trying to charge this little filly here? And can we actually talk?
They don't listen, and they... Now that they're closer, it looks like some of them seem to be like almost like pony-shaped robots. Not like Protectrons or Securitrons, but actual like pony-looking metallic robot things. Like something out of an old sci-fi serial. And there also seem to be a few hovering sprite bots with them, providing fire support.
Oh, god damn it, I've got the Nuka World song stuck in my head again.
Alright,
Should we just kill him?
The filly runs and hides behind the cart. The tipped-over cart. Cowering and crying.
Good. She knows the standard MOP operating procedure when you're being attacked. Excellent.
We're about to be attacked.
Yes. As a matter of fact, I'd like you all to roll for initiative.
Initiative. Oh.
Fun.
It's never roll for kittens. It's always roll for combat.
What are we rolling for initiative here?
It's just a straight 1d20 unless you have a trait or something that provides a modifier.
I almost took one. I almost took one, and I decided, nope.
Oh, Jeebus.
And I should have taken it.
That's fine.
I'm going to cry a little bit, sorry.
Oh, don't worry. It's the Wanderlust combat system. You can't die.
He's not wrong. All right, so if I'm reading that right, Razor Pillar got a 15. Jackknife got a 19. Crash Cart got a 20.
Digo, you're wasting your 20s.
And Nocturne got a 2.
You're wasting your 2s.
I'm just hiding behind the cart, and I have to be pulled out to actually fight. This is my logic.
You're hiding with the filly?
I'm not a fighter. I'm a thief. What do you want from me?
To defend yourself Murder. Occasionally? Razor Bullet, could you roll again? You tied.
Oh, can do.
All right.
Just gradually get higher. Let me roll another 4 times.
So, the order goes, give me a second. Order goes Crash Cart, Jackknife, which is, I still can't believe I let you get away with that name, Razor Pillow, and Nocturne. And between them, between Jackknife and Razor Pillow, there's a couple of pony mechs, and between Razor Pillow and Nocturne, there's 3 sprite bots.
So, I'm basically going last, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Posting it in Rando Central, the Discord chat.
Sweet.
Wonder if I should make a text channel just for, like, tabletop note-taking stuff. I don't know. A question to ask later. So, Crash Cart, you rolled a 20, so I'll let you take a free standard just to start things off as a surprise round.
I'm gonna go ahead and pull out a scalpel and toss it at the first mech coming up the hill at me.
All right.
Single attack deals 2d8 damage to target creature.
That's reflavored arrow. So mm-hmm. You're just literally tossing it and hoping that the sharp end lands in in the bad guy.
Yeah. Lands in the bad guy, who is a robotic pony for all intents and purposes. All
right, that's a 6 damage on, let's say, the first or the second pony mech.
First pony mech.
First pony mech. Got it. Jackknife. Oh wait, no. Crash again. Now you're full round.
All right. I'm going to turn to Jackknife, and I'm going to use Inspire. Target creature deals an additional 8 damage to the target of its next single attack power.
This is going to be beautiful.
I was going to go, Jackknife, why don't you take over? You can do it. You can win.
Oh my gosh.
Abridged jokes. Anyway, is that it?
I'll just stick by the filly, and that's about it.
Yep, that's your standard. You don't really have... Well, you do have a minor you could use, but you might not want to use that right now, so... So Jackknife's turn, then.
So, Pony Mech number 2. All right. I'm gonna start with, did I break that? Guard break. Target creature loses all armor and resistance until end of the turn.
Ah. That is an action.
Which I will then go and use Swish and Flick, which is Flourish. Hey, Nocturne. You might need this. And throws a bit of food over. So Nocturne gets an extra 5 HP.
You don't gain life above the maximum, right?
Yeah, you do.
You do.
You can get up to infinite life in this system because it hates you in fun.
There's infinite life gain. Oh, I see. All right, so...
That's beautiful.
And then I'm going to use some of my...
To clarify, I should have said this at the start. This is Wanderlust we're using, which is sort of Ponytail's 3rd edition. So it's in the same vein and questionably differently balanced.
That's one way of putting it.
And now I'm going to use the four from my Vigilant to use the reaction, which I've called Rules of Nature, Rage of the Dragon. Deal 1d4 plus 1d6 plus 1d8 plus 1d10 plus 1d12, given the 1d8 from Crash Cart. Was it just 8?
It's just 8, and yeah, it's a single attack, so you do get to apply it.
And an extra 1d6 from Crackshot.
Question, did anyone not take Crackshot?
I'm a doctor, not a combatant.
It's a really good exalted trait.
Yeah, it is. So all the cool people, good to know.
We're all great people.
You're getting healed.
I'm getting healed, and I'm not going to die.
I'll add the 8 onto the 1d4.
All right. 11 plus 5. No, wait, that's 2d6 you just rolled in that.
Crackshot.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait, Diego, do you have the upgrade as well for Crackshot? Because that would explain why.
No, I think he said he doesn't have the up. Oh. Doesn't have Crackshot.
Then I'm reading things wrong. This is great.
Well, hearing.
Hearing. Staring at the rolls chat, also reading.
Oh, it was 5, it was 4, 20, 22, 32 damage. Is that? Oh, boy.
I forgot to do a thing, but I can do that next turn. Never mind.
Well, it's still your turn. You haven't quite ended it yet, but...
Yeah, but I should have done it before my attack.
All right, then. So yep. The first pony mech lifts up its laser rifle and fires it at the pony who just attacked. So jackknife.
Rules of nature!
It usually, like, rules of nature is more of a finisher, not a... I dealt a big amount of damage to you, but...
To be fair, it is a monk finisher.
I suppose.
Did we all just jump into the monk?
Monk OP.
Monk is very OP.
Monk is weird.
Having seen someone play, like, a really dedicated monk build, monks are OP.
Yeah. I don't know if I plan on making Wanderlust my regular system, but it's a good go-to. All right, anyway, so the attack. Jackknife, you take 16 damage.
Well, that goes down to 11 because I have armor 5, right?
Yep, that's how that works. And then the second mech picks, well, I don't know, Razor Pillow as its target.
Why not?
Dealing 19 damage.
Cool.
Alright, now it's Razor Pillow's turn.
Sweet. Okay, so all of my features and stuff kick in. So, my feature kicks in, giving me 2 energy at the start of my turn. Then, Quick Draw kicks in, giving me an additional 2 energy that can only be used on minor actions. Thank you. Alright, so for my first, I will use Devouring Blade for -4. So target creature suffers weakness 9. So I'll do it on the first Prenny mech. The next single attack power you use also, deals an additional 9 damage to its target.
Alright.
Then I will... So 7... 3. Then I will use Arrow, which is just... deal 2d8 damage to target creature. I will add my crack shot and my crack shot upgrade to it, so I do an additional 2d6 on top of that. So it's 2d8, 2d6 plus 9 to Penny Mech. 1. For 21 damage, no crits.
And this.
Oh, and add an extra 9 onto that because of its weakness.
Because of its weakness. And that's on
so that's
the,
29.
And that was on the first Pony Mech?
Yes.
All right. So the total was, again...
will be 30 if we add on the extra 9.
Yep. That's a solid 30 damage. Hot dang. All right.
And
you've dealt significant damage to these two, but it's a little hard to tell if they've reached bloodied state. You're not quite sure yet. You've kind of taken chunks of them off, but they don't seem to respond with any sort of appearance of limping or weakness. Anyway, it's the sprite bots get to all go, and each one of them uses the same thing, which is just a rapid-fire spray of lasers to try and hit just about all of you.
Joy.
Fun.
It's kind of a complicated amount of dice, because it's like adjacency, so there's 3 targets here, 3 targets there. Give me a second. Okay... That comes to 9 damage to Crash, 12 damage to Jackknife, 12 damage to Razor Pillow, and 4 damage to Nocturne.
Bee.
I did not roll terribly well.
I'm still above 100.
Even. All right, now it's Nocturne's turn.
It's
the Nocturne.
Boom, boom.
But,
beautiful, I love it. Okay. First, I'm going to use the feature, which is Poison Blaze, a reflavored Hexer, and use the minor utility for Hex and use it on one of the sprite bots.
A first, second, or third, just so I know.
The first one.
All right. Hexed.
So that is, choose a creature. The creature becomes hexed until the battle ends, or you use this power again. When the hexed creature starts its turn, it takes 5 damage and suffers weakness 6.
That's pretty bad. All right.
And then I'm just going to slash that same sprite bot.
All right. That'll be a 2d6. Which comes to 10.
Ah, my rolls. They're beautiful.
All right. Top of the initiative, then. Crash cart.
All right. Bit. Okay, so what crash? For the standard, he's going to apply first aid. Target creature gains 1d8 plus 10 life. Let's see. Between jackknife and razor pillow, I think razor pillow looks a little more injured.
Oh, you go for. Hi. Ah, I've just got an anonymous gopher on my sheet. I kind of assumed it was you.
Oh.
That's possibly me? No, I'm logged in.
So, anyway, yeah, I've got 69.
Okay.
Yeah, he's definitely more beat up than I am.
1d8 plus 10.
Crits all the things.
Not quite.
Not quite. Well, that's 12.
Woo! I get back all my sprite bot damage.
Better than nothing. And then I'll go ahead and, with a minor action, quick draw syringe. Minor action, single attack, deal 2d6 damage to target creature. Throwing that at the same pony mech that I attacked before, which was number 1.
Alright, that's the one that has the weakness on it.
Yes, it does.
So you roll a 4, but it has weakness 9, so it takes a total of 13.
Yay! Would be my turn.
Alright, Jackknife.
Jackknife is going to start bouncing on a who's energetic. And look at one of the 2 undamaged sprite bots. Then, yeah, going to start off with Withering Blade, which I've named Sting Like a Crocodile, Float Like a Breezy.
Mm-hmm.
So next single attack I do also causes the target to suffer weakness 5.
Noted.
Then did I break that? Swish and flick with Razor Pillow gaining 5 additional health. And then into Rules of Nature.
Alright, the opener, the combo, and the... Yeah, monks.
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 I mean, which, give me a moment and I can... right.
Running among.
You know, it's energetic that really kind of... Oh, yeah.
Energetic is broken and should be nerfed immediately.
I might ban that the next next Wanderlust game I do. I might just have to make a ban list.
Makes sense. So, on the... Either one of the 2 sprite bots that aren't broken.
That haven't been... So, the your Rage of the Dragon, your Rules of Nature.
Yep.
You're targeting...
The one that hasn't been hit by Noctem.
Well, there's 2 of them. So either the second one or the third one.
Third one.
All right, the third one. It gets the weakness 5 and the total of your combo damage. So if you could roll all that. You can add them up in the rolls room, just so you know.
Force of habit, I'm sorry.
No problem. It's also kind of fun to just kind of line them all up. Ooh.
I've done 2d6 twice. My mistake.
I'll just take the first one, and it's bigger, so... So 3 and 10, and 9 and 9 and 5. That's with the crack shot, too. Oy.
I completely forgot about crack shot on my turn.
13, 22, 31, 36. 36 damage and weakness 5.
Yep.
On the third one. Yeah, you kind of just took a huge chunk out of it with... How does your character attack? Like, what weapons or techniques? Is it just like martial arts, or?
She's going to pull out her combat knife, jump on it, and start hacking at it.
You're just tearing through iron and plastic.
She will use her teeth if she has to.
Oy. All right, then. Well, that's a significant amount of damage to that bot. So the mech, number one, fires up again, dealing 16 damage to Nocturne.
Ow.
Pony mech number two, firing at Crash Cart for 19 damage.
Ow.
Razor Pillow.
Hello.
It is your turn.
Cool. So I get two from energetic, which puts me to six. I get another two for my thing, which puts me to eight. So the weakness nine is still there?
Good question.
Because it never says, and that always threw me.
Suffers weakness nine. Does suffer automatically imply a save ends, or? I'm going to say it's still on.
Oh, neat. In that case, I will just be boring, and I will spend four, to do Heartseeker, which is deal 4d12 damage, and I'll deal it to Pony Mech 1 still alive?
Yep.
Cool, I'll do it to Pony Mech 1. So that's 4d12 plus 2d6 for my thing, plus 9. 40. No crits. Yeah, no crits.
Yeah, but you reach into its heart and tear it out, basically. It falls over, nearly bisected.
Amazing.
Pony Mech 1 is out.
So we know for certain that they're actually mechs now.
Yep. They are just about 100% mechanical. The sprite bots pay no heed. The other pony-shaped mech kind of, wouldn't say recoils or has a big reaction, but does kind of take a step to the side, just kind of warily. The sprite bots all use their barrage attacks again.
Dope.
So, I should have thought of a simpler attack pattern than this. Crash takes 11 damage. Jackknife takes 14. Razor Pillow takes 9. Nocturne takes 8.
I'm under 100 life now.
God damn it.
Now, this needs that.
This wasn't meant to be an encounter to kill you that much, anyway. Also, the Hexed One takes 5 damage and gains weakness 6, does it not?
Yes.
That's how that works. Okay. Nocturne's turn. And I'm not going to make the pun again. I swear.
I am so immune to puns because my own name has one that's used to death.
You mean... okay.
Yeah. The echo part of it.
Yeah.
I accepted that pain and suffering. Anyway. I am... I thought I figured this out before I started, but...
It just kind of blank on you?
Yes, it did. I think I figured it out. I have first the standard action of Easy Does It, which is Reflavored Take Aim, which is your next single attack power deals an additional 1d12 to its target. And I'm not going to forget about Crackshot and the upgrade this time either. And I'm just going to use Quickshot as the free action, which is deals base 7 to target creature. And then I'm going to roll all that other stuff. Shoot.
Yeah, you got to have a little dash or something in front of it.
I completely forgot about it.
It's easy to forget. Don't worry.
So then all of that is 16 plus the base 7 to the one with weakness 6. So I guess it's plus.
You take your shot at the first sprite bot, and it explodes. It just blows
Yay!
Up.
Yay! Beautiful.
Crash's turn.
Did her D6s both roll sixes?
Yeah, but I don't. That doesn't trigger specials.
Oh, okay.
It's eights, tens, and twelves.
That's right. Okay. All right, how guys? How are we doing? Health.
Well, I mean, I could always use another 150, but, you know.
Here's but a scratch.
But a scratch, all right. All right. It's complaining. Or screaming bloody murder. Go ahead and my standard action. I'll stab that mech number two again with my scalpel. 2d8.
For a total of 12. A lot of near crits this, this encounter. All right.
Let me go ahead. Minor action again. Quick draw syringe and do another 2d6.
All right. If six is critted, oh boy.
Yeah, right. All right.
All right. It's looking like it's held together with a spit and a prayer, but it's not quite non-functional yet. Jackknife?
I'm going to use the blood of my enemies, as well as known as Vampiric Blade, and then Heartseeker on the drone that I'm on.
How can you draw life from your enemies if they're robotic?
Kittens. Ask Raiden.
Well, Raiden has
robots Raiden, have feelings too.
Raiden has an answer. He's, you know, drawing.
Fine.
It's Metal Gear. There's always an absurdly lengthy and ultimately nonsensical explanation. You see, the sword absorbs their electrolytes.
I get a crit.
Uh-oh, you did get a you got a 12 in there. Yep.
Yay!
Nice.
So your special
Sorcerer's Lightning, 1d20 damage to target creature, 1d10 to random enemy.
All right. Roll a 1d3 in rolls to determine the random enemy.
2.
All right, that'll be the first sprite bot. Or the first remaining sprite bot.
Did that just happen?
Oi!
Yes.
You rolled a 20 on a d20 and a 10 on a d10, which also means that your Sorcerer's Lightning triggers again.
All three!
Also, what was your chosen target for the 20 part of that?
Did it break the one that I was on? My original attack?
Well, I mean, it's target creature, so you can choose any target you want.
It would have been the one I was on. I want to make sure I kill that thing.
The mech? Or
Spritebot 2.
Alright, the one that you randomly chose? Alright, so you deal solid 30 damage to that thing, and your special triggers again.
I'll start with the one. No crit that time.
Oh, it's not the same special as last time. I mean the 10 special, D12 and D8, not D20 and D10.
I thought the D20 natural D20 activates all three.
Does it?
I think there are specials that do
there,
that.
There are specials that no, yeah. There's powers and specials that say if you roll a 20, it's like it's the Crit Fisher ones, where if you roll a 20, you activate all three. But that's not a default
that's
feature
my mistake,
of the system.
It'll be.
So no, if any D20, if any natural 20 activated all three of your specials, sessions would just be full of people randomly exploding, and I don't think any DM could handle that.
No, I'm sorry, that's my mistake. So yeah, the target is the mech 2.
All right.
And
the random
another
one?
Another D3?
Yeah.
3.
That'll be the second sprite bot.
Everything burns.
Remind none of us to get on your wrong side.
So 10 damage to the mech, and 5 damage modified for a sprite bot. The
Azul Mountain pointed out when you roll a 20 on a d20 in combat, you may trigger all three of your specials.
That is at the top of this page for specials.
Would you like me to check for you?
He's super. Nope. He's right.
Yep. All right, roll all three of your specials, too.
I roll initiative. I get a 20. Activate. Oh my god, you fucking did that.
Okay, Crash Cart, roll all your specials too.
What?
You rolled a 20 in combat.
The second D20 plus D10.
No, I gave you a surprise round instead. I guess that's not really the same.
The second one.
It's been a while since I've done Wanderlust.
Because I won't reroll that second D20 plus D10. That can go into or the Pony Neck one.
How about they just all explode? How about we're done rolling dice and they just all blow up? Jackknife just goes into a frenzy.
It's a beautiful pile of fireworks.
Azure says, I don't think initiative counts as combat. I don't know.
I'm so sorry, Spot.
They just all explode.
Toasty.
Wanderlust combat is awesome when you're a player. That's true.
Yep.
That's true.
And that's about the only time.
I feel so bad right now.
It's basically what the system's designed for, it's for people like me to suffer and for you guys to feel awesome. All right.
If you didn't do it now, one of us would have done it later.
I mean, you're not wrong. You are not incorrect.
How's the little girl?
You want to go back and check on the little girl?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
So we're done?
Yeah, the combat is over.
Cool.
Hooray!
The robots are starting to decompose extremely quickly.
I know I was making Nuka-Cola jerks before, but crisp.
They just seem to be, like, dissolving incredibly quickly to leave no trace.
Who makes dissolving robots? Words. Murder.
Anyway, you go back to behind the cart, the tipped over cart, to check on the filly. And you notice the filly is not where she was hiding, and the lock on the back door seems to have been unlocked, and the door is slightly ajar.
This is why I never wanted kids.
Can I repeat myself? I hate children.
No one expected a filly intrusion.
Everyone expects the filly.
You hear the filly inside start whimpering as you approach the door.
Opening door.
You just shove the door open and you see the filly just kind of huddled in one very tight corner. And you notice that the immediate area around her, including parts of the server banks, have been bedazzled with stickers. Stickers of stars, of rainbows, of clouds. Just stickers everywhere.
Everything about this child makes me sad inside.
Where's that dragon?
Wow.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, the filly cries out. I just wanted somewhere to hide. I'm good with locks, but it just was so dark and cold in here, and I just wanted to make myself feel more comfortable in case this was going to be the end or something. I'm sorry. She starts climbing out of the compartment.
See if she's lying.
You can roll insight.
Because this is seeming just weird insight.
When she climbs out, I'm going to reach in and start pulling off the stickers.
I'm going to join you.
How about we don't do it, pull out the stickers, just in case it pulls out anything important? Do you want to explain to the Applejack Rangers why there are broken files?
Do you want to go in there with the thing covered in stickers and tell them that a little filly got past our defenses and could have broken all our stuff?
We could have just explained it, or we could just explain that we were attacked by melting robots. None of this seems normal.
I'm going to join them in taking off the stickers and poking around the
First things first, the insight check. As things are right now, it's just she started to climb out after saying all this, and I guess Jackknife rolls the insight check? Is it?
Yep.
Just him? You roll a 25?
Yep.
You have a 12 bonus in insight. Not shabby. You definitely think she's putting on a very innocent act.
Growing up by the scruff of the neck.
Hey! What are you doing?
Please don't lie to us.
Am I going to have to kill a child today? Is this a thing that's going to happen? Because I'm not getting paid enough to kill children today.
Is there a reason we need to kill a child?
No one has to know.
Okay, listen here, little filly. As the rest of these people just witnessed, I may, with of course with their help, just destroyed an entire bunch of robots. Please don't mess with us.
I swear, I don't know where those robots came from. I was just looking to add to my sticker collection, because my name is Sticker Style, and that's my cutie mark. And I got that last week, and I was looking in this old base, and these robots just came to life while I was looking around. I must have hit like a console or something, and I'm just really scared.
Okay, kid, where's your parents or your guardians or whoever
They're
the hell
dead.
Is looking after you?
Raise a pillow. Welcome to parenthood. Shove.
I vote we just.
Nope, I'm going to.
I vote we keep. We let her go back to her parents.
Oi.
You son. That's dumb.
Hey, I don't want to deal with her. I'll, you know, sort of double tap her on the double tap her on the skull and be like, if is there anywhere close we can like drop you?
The filly gets a really just sort of shocked look on her face. And she looks very distracted and says, I don't know. My home was destroyed by raiders a while back, so I."
So then where have you been staying since then?
Oh, well, you know, under broken roofs and in, you know.
Who sent you?
In Gold Rush, and no one sent me. I came here all on my own. I'm a strong filly. I can usually find my way around.
How long have you been on your own?
I've been on my own for like a couple of months now. I saw that whole like big dragon thing go on.
This is all seeming a bit too strange. Everything.
Nocturne's going to go over to the filly, tap her head, and get down on her level. Now
she looks even more scared now.
Honey, now I don't think you want to make either of any of these others angry. So can you please tell us who is the nearest other pony that you've been with? Because leaving you on your own is not something I believe any of them want to do.
Okay.
She is sort of completely just scared stiff for a second and starts crying. Just big old crocodile tears.
Sorry, but what was your name again?
It's Sticker Style.
And you said you wanted to add these stickers into your collection, correct?
I thought there were these stickers in the place where I found the robots, and then they started chasing me. I guess I triggered some kind of...
Right, I'm calling bull on the story already. She's already changed minor details.
What? No,
I'm calling bullshit on the grounds that if they're her sticker collection, why did she put them on our stuff?
Because those are ones I have duplicates of.
She also initiated that she went into this box to put the stickers on.
No, I went there to hide, and then I felt really scared, so I put stickers on to make myself feel better.
So you just decided to randomly decorate someone else's stuff.
I'm gonna get
stickers.
I pull out my straight razor, and I'm like, look, we're going to solve this problem really quickly.
No!
Whoa, that's, on. That might be a little...
Have fun with that. I'm going to go take off those stickers.
I want to see, what kind of stickers are these?
The annoying kind. Join
well,
me.
They're
come
really,
off.
Really
sticker
cutesy.
Sticker style, please. We're giving you the best chance. We just want to know what's going on. I'm asking you as politely and nicely as I can. Please, could you just give us the entire truth, and we can help you. There's something wrong. If you wanted to go to this place where there's robots, or whatever they are, we can try and help you. But we can't help you unless you tell us everything and make sure it's the truth. No lying, we will find out.
I did.
Except you didn't, because you're full of crap. So let's try this again.
Can I roll another insight check?
Yes.
Because it's looking mighty peculiar to me.
You don't say. That's a 28. With your incredible powers of insight, you can see that her sort of attitude isn't really changing or breaking, but it seems like she's going to stick to this story, even though it seems like you're not buying it.
Well, we're not going to buy his story. Raise a pillow. If you want to do your thing, she's not going to change. We know she's lying.
Candor!
If I do shot, kid.
Anyone who doesn't want to see this may want to leave now for a bit. This is not going to be pleasant for anyone who's not used to it. Trust me.
Jackknife, roll reflexes.
I wasn't even the closest one, but sure.
You're the one holding her.
I threw her to Razor Pillow.
Oh. Razor Pillow, roll reflexes.
Aw, my reflexes are like 6.
Good luck.
22.
That's pretty good. But with an astonishing and almost unnatural speed and strength, the filly wrestles out of your grip and starts booking it.
All right, what do I need to roll to throw my razor into her head?
Dexterity. But straight razors are not known for their potential as throwing knives.
They are not, but I'm too lazy to run. 12. Wow, that's awful.
She's already out of reach by the time you toss your razor limply across the desert.
Good take job. That!
Righty. Beesitters of the year.
That's because I'm pretty certain she's like one of those robots out there.
I think
that's
so.
That's crazy. She's just...
I place 100 caps on it.
More likely she's just working for some raider gang or other who, you know, thought they could size us up and hoped a filly would make us lower our guard. Seen it before, been there before.
It's very likely, especially since she got into the cart so easily, if her skill is stickers.
In fairness, well, how many raiders have wrestled their way out of your grip?
I don't know.
Did we get all the stickers out?
Well, now you can actually start, you know.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I ran off to do that long ago.
No. Sorry, I had to handle one thing at a time, so...
No, it's okay.
I assumed that this was front and center.
No, it's okay. I ran off while everyone was yelling. Because I wasn't going to contribute, and Nocturne was just, like, not going to say anything else.
Alright, so...
Nocturne is like, I don't condone violence against children today of all days.
It's just like, kill him, let's go, let's get rid of the stickers.
I don't condone violence against children, but that wasn't a child.
Well, I will go and collect my my straight razor, and then I will go and examine the box.
The cart.
Make sure there's nothing else loitering around on it.
It doesn't seem to be. It looks like the server racks have been kind of bumped around a little bit in when the wheel gave out.
All right.
I'm going to wait until the two inside are done with the stickers. Give it a quick check around.
So you all start to take off the stickers then?
Yes.
I'll, yeah, do my thing and help out with that.
If there's glitter on any of us after this, I swear.
There's a bit of glitter on Jackknife and Razor Pillow's hooves.
I'm gonna cut.
you cut out, so that was perfect.
All the shiny.
Alright, well.
Roll perception, everyone who's undoing the stickers.
God fucking damn it. Everyone?
Yep. If you said you're wanting to take off the stickers.
15.
Oh, wait, what are we rolling?
Perception.
I can't throw or see.
I could explain the other.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's fair.
All right, there's...
My rolls are shit.
I'm getting older like today.
I hate you.
Jackknife, while you're... Jackknife, you notice more stickers hidden in kind of sort of... Sorry.
No, it's when you're kind of cutting out at the moment.
Okay. Am I still audible?
Yes.
Okay. Jackknife, you notice a few stickers in kind of crafty hidden places. And you also notice like what looks like a tiny dead ladybug sitting on one of the racks.
I squish it and throw it out.
Gosh. You sure it was dead?
It is now.
Does Nightwatch or One Eye Open help me at all in this area as well?
Nightwatch and One Eye Open.
Nightwatch, you can
see in the dark. Well, you're not asleep, and...
You can still do it with your eyes closed.
Oh, yeah. And it's a little dark in there, but I'm already kind of taking that into account.
But yeah, okay, I'll take the stickers off, and in the... I'm going to try and replace the ladybug with a neat little spider.
What's that?
Was that, sorry?
What's that supposed to do?
In my line of work, if you don't have a tracking device on everything, it's going to go missing. So if someone comes up again and breaks into it like last time, that little girl takes it or whatever, I'd rather be able to go and track it and know where it is.
Sure, you wouldn't just prefer one of us, you know, stay in here?
I'll take first watch.
We don't need to be stuffing stuff in.
At the moment, I'm just tired and I just want the money.
Well, none of you are going anywhere until the wheel gets repaired anyway.
We don't need to be putting bugs in the system, figuratively and literally.
At least not at the moment.
Again,
I can understand once we're on the move, though.
Yeah.
Take your stuff.
Perhaps before we start talking about who should be taking watch, maybe we should fix the wheel, because otherwise we're going nowhere fast.
Who's good at fixing things?
If it's a pony, I'm really good at fixing it.
Who's got the best general knowledge?
That'll probably be me.
Mr. All the Practical Skills. Oh, geez, yeah, 15.
Is it magical? I can go higher.
Well, Crash Cart has a 17 heal, so it's not the highest skill in the party.
Who has a skill of a 10? I thought I would be good not min-max once.
I just went with what felt right for the character. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
If it was Jax, I would have been fine.
Playing what you want to play. What an absurd notion.
So would you like me to roll general knowledge then?
Yeah, roll general knowledge to see if you can summon up the know-how to repair a metal wheel.
I love you, Orange Jesus.
Wow, nice.
Yeah.
I bet you know, when we most need it, I'm rolling nothing but natural ones.
Wow, that's a... So, yeah, with just a few, maybe some bits of wood, some nails, some stuff like that, you could probably fashion together the other half of the wheel you need. You just need resources and time.
It's just like Mother's first AK-47. All you need is wood.
Okay.
Okay.
You can actually.
I am stealing that. That's amazing.
All right, let me make sure I didn't miss anything in direct messages. Okay.
Only a bit where I asked if I could kill everyone, but I kind of assumed she just ignored that out of stupidity on my part.
All right. You don't currently have the materials on you, but there is a ruined building nearby with kind of a like a wooden sort of what's the word I'm looking for? Kind of ranger station.
Which one of you are the strongest?
And look at me. I'm all like murder people in their sleep, so you know, physical strength isn't my, you know, big thing.
I just throw myself at things and stab it until it dies.
I can slip in. I can slip in and see if stuff's there, but if it's big, I'm probably not getting it out.
What exactly are we looking for?
enough wood and stuff to actually fix this wheel.
All right. Well, I can get in, do reconnaissance, get back out if that helps.
As long as you want my Nocturne as a partner, I mean, aren't two scouts better than one?
Yeah, I was going to say buddy system.
Yeah, I can do that.
Fine. Let's hope there's no more of those robot ponies in there.
In the meantime, Crash Cart, since you did all the pudding and did that fight, would you like a rest?
That would be pretty awesome. Yes, thank you.
Before we go, I will activate stealth mode. And as I'm sort of like disappearing, it's just stealthy meek stealthison. Scout extraordinaire.
You're crouched and suddenly, where'd he go? Where'd she go?
I also do stealth mode.
Two
stealth mode buddies.
Two yes! Crouching ponies.
This is the best plan.
What can possibly go wrong?
Everything.
Nah, it's fine. To the building.
All right.
Away.
So you two approach the building. As you approach, roll perception as well.
No, seeing is hard.
Razor Pillow, you suspect there might be something kind of in the ruins. You might want to, like, take a long way around to try and avoid them, or at least get the drop on them.
All right, I will do that.
I'm going to follow.
Actually, that's a good point. Seeing as we're both in stealth mode, can we see each other?
Yes, you can see each other.
Let's go, Polo.
Razor, pillow. Razor, pillow. Because you have the two-part name and I don't.
How to drive Spud insane in less than 5 minutes.
I'm only half sorry.
Nice, you cut yourselves short. You kind of go around the back and notice that there seem to be two more robot mechs just sort of standing watch. Not really guarding anything particular, just sort of lying in wait, but in the wrong direction now that you've gone around.
I vote we just skip them and enter the building.
Well, the building is half destroyed. It's pretty much all revealed to the open air. They are inside in the sense that they are standing where the giant hole is.
Oh, right.
Can I use face step, which I can also allow Razor Pillow to use?
Sweet.
We're going right through the wall.
You can do that. You can phase through the walls of the building without the robo ponies noticing. And inside is just a bunch of usable rubble and some hardware and tools as well. Seems like there's a whole emergency kit in there.
Neat.
Awesome.
Some healing bandages and potions as well.
Ooh.
Extra score for the scouts. Guess we'll grab that and go back the way we came.
Yeah, since phase step is still basically active, let me reread that real quick.
It's for 10 minutes.
Yeah, and can phase through solid objects at will. So, yeah, you can pick a bunch of stuff up and then sneak back around and back to the cart without the mechs in the building noticing.
Stealthy bits for the win!
Heck yeah!
Well done. And Jackknife, now that they've gathered up some materials for you, you can get to work on repairing the wheel.
Fixing, 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 fixing.
I'm gonna sing the doomsday.
Roll dexterity.
Natural 20.
Jeez.
Thank you, RNG Jesus.
Wow.
Jackknife, OP. Slaughter immediately.
Kill him. Let's go.
Kill her.
Kill her. Sorry.
All right. Well, you get the wheel fixed in record time, and it's as sturdy as it was when it was whole. You can close the door, although the locks...
Before you close the door, I have an idea, if you want to hear me out on this.
I doubt it'll be the worst idea we've had today, so go for it.
Well, I have a pet with me.
Yeah, what?
A pet. I have a... It's my lucky grasshopper. I call him Bart. I'll pull out from a little box my pack, little grasshopper. Hey, they're very lucky. Especially makes them lucky is that this is probably the first grasshopper I've seen in 8 months that isn't the size of a Corvega.
It's a Corvega.
Read a book sometime. Okay. Bart's pretty well trained. I figure we can put him in the box. If something starts messing, trying to get into the box, he'll start chirping. And that's a pretty distinctive sound, so that'll alert us that somebody's opened the box.
I see three problems with this already. One, we're moving, and with those wheels, especially now that one's wooden, we will not be able to hear the chirping over enclosed space. That is going to be loud.
Two, I've heard a grasshopper.
The grasshopper could be loud enough.
Could.
You want to make the grasshopper start chirping?
No.
As a demonstration?
I don't know the biology well enough of a grasshopper to know how much oxygen it needs and how long it will survive in that echo chamber.
There are vents. It is not airtight. It's just cooled. And tight physically.
Spud, stop poking holes in my logic.
I get your plan, but, and I activate miniaturize again, I could do the same thing, just more effectively. Because unlike the grasshopper, I can fight back.
Yes, yeah, but then they already say back at the base they don't want any of us touching it, really.
Who needs to touch it?
It's a very enclosed space.
And I'm tiny.
Yeah,
just
which
what I am.
You're not going to be able to fight back all that much.
No, but it's fine, because I can revert back to normal size.
And crush the servers.
How about this instead? Since when we're moving, one of us, or one, because three of us are flyers, one of us could fly behind and watch the door. If we stop, for whatever reason, one of us does not leave the cart. Since that's what seemed to have created this problem in the first place.
Combo move. Yep, no, I agree with you.
I suppose. Combo.
Sorry, I had an idea and it's great. It's also really dumb. So, I'm still miniaturized, right? And I can basically stay miniaturized for however long I need to. We have three flyers. I jump on the back of one of the flyers. They fly around. If something happens, I jump off and halfway down unminiaturize and stab it in the face.
Death from above.
Oh, jeez.
Forgive me if I'm mistaken, Mr. Your weight or mass doesn't change.
You shrink down to the size of a mouse. Your might is proportionally shrunk. You don't take numeric penalties, but you can't still lift or push things as though you were normal size. You can spend 1 second of mental effort to return to normal size. It does not say it. No, your weight and strength do not. They do change. That is the verdict. They do definitely change.
So basically, if you try to stab something as a miniature, it would be like getting a pinprick.
Yeah, but
I only need 1 second of mental effort to not be miniature anymore.
It is a valid plan.
Why do I get the mental image of you're just going to stop base jumping, forget to get bigger at the very last moment, and as you do, you've already hit the floor?
It's like halfway down. I know I'm forgetting something.
But we don't. If someone's behind the cart flying, or if it's you and just walking, we don't... One of us is going to see something happening before then, so you would kind of be moot point.
But the opposite is also true. They can see us coming.
You're not exactly a stealthy company to begin with.
If they got that close, it would have been on us not to notice them coming that close.
So, guys, what are you traveling? A mechanized porta potty?
Yes.
Yes.
Roll persuasion.
I'll do it.
What? I'm sorry, I missed something. What?
We've just become the Jackknife Porta Potty Delivery Service.
Hey, why are we using your name?
Because I already have a mercenary company.
because I doubt anybody wants to sit on a porta potty made by a razor pillow.
Good times, that one.
Yes, but calling it jackknife makes it sound like there are knives in the potty. So let's not.
To be fair,
I am so lost. Jackknife
once.
Don't worry, Spud, we're just talking about toilets.
I don't understand how right. toilets got into the conversation, though.
I don't know, I'm just... Okay, all right, let's do this.
So all no right. base jumping? I'm sad now.
So nothing in the box. So all the stickers are out. Get out yep. the spider. No spiders. No grasshopper. Sorry, Bart. But
yeah.
All right. Close the door.
I already took the spider out, remember? You then put in the idea of your grasshopper.
No, there's no bugs going in there. No bugs.
There is no bugs in there.
Good.
Exactly.
Didn't Jackknife explicitly say he was putting a spider on, though?
He took it out.
Oh, he took it out? Okay.
I'm staying tiny. I'm not getting bigger in this. I have to.
All right.
Then
so, the door. We in agreement?
Agreement on what?
Closing the door.
We're a toilet company.
We're going back to the way
we
it
had
was.
This conversation.
Two ponies are going to carry the cart. One of us, whether it's a Pegasus or it's Razor Pillow, is going to trail behind and watch the door. If we stop, someone stays with the cart.
Yes.
Yes.
I still want to do base jumping, though.
You can base jump later.
So yes. is the miniature thing happening, or...?
No, I'm going to throw Razor Pillow at a dragon the next time I see it.
You can
base jump off that.
Where is everybody?
Okay, I will unminiaturize, and I will stay behind the cart.
You're going to try and trail behind as the size of a mouse behind a cart?
No, I'll unminiaturize.
I think I'm still good for pulling the cart, so I'm just going to saddle back up with that.
I will put Bart on top of the cart. He can be our little watch grasshopper.
Oh, my gosh.
Like a hood ornament. And I'll go ahead and...
Heal him? He's worth something?
Little buddy. And I guess I'll hook up to the cart as well.
Neat.
Off we go again.
So, yay. So Razor Pillow is where one more time?
Behind the cart.
Miniaturized.
No.
Not miniaturized.
Oh, okay.
I mean...
Or else Echo is going to throw me into a dragon.
You could be...
We will go right back to that dragon and throw you.
You could be miniaturized on Crimson Sky's back.
Yeah, but then ooh. Crimson has to be in the back.
She has no problem with this.
Okay, then.
All right. Doing that, then.
So, Crash Cart's pulling the cart.
Yes.
Jackknife's falling behind. Razor Pillow is miniaturized and on Jackknife's back. And Nocturne's watching, trailing behind from above.
No, I was also pulling the cart as well.
Oh. You're also pulling the cart then, Nocturne?
Yeah, because we had two ponies doing it at the beginning, so...
No, I think you only have one.
Oh!
You said different? Two.
Two? All right, then two.
It's easier.
This is fine.
We just rig it with a natural 20 so we can pull it with two now. Problem solved.
But now this makes more sense because now there's two ponies in the front and two in the back.
All right.
Yay.
And it's great because I don't have to walk. I can just look behind this.
You're carrying the cart next.
Oh, but I'm tiny and adorable. I can't carry carts.
Don't make me do an aileron roll.
Oh.
We agree to switch every so often, and my eyes are on you.
Wow.
I see a romance blossoming.
If I had more than two stealth modes, I'd use it just for the sake of a joke, but...
Oh, I gotta save the stealth mode.
I know, it's so irritating.
Yeah, but I have face step, so...
Face step OP.
Alright, so after much discussion, you start steadily getting a move on?
I guess.
Well, we're not getting paid to sit around. I mean, that'd be a lovely job.
That is true. So you start down the path leading south and around the mountain, heading towards the vault, or stable. Gotta keep my Fallout and Fallout Equestria terms straight. There's a bit more time without any interruptions. The massive dragon passes by overhead. A merchant walks up and hails you down and offers some of his wares, but doesn't have anything really worth mentioning.
I can't remember. We're not evil, are we?
Huh?
Priestess at the moment.
I was so tempted to just say, kill him. Remember what happened with the filly. But let's not.
So good.
Well, I mean, he has stuff, so I mean, if we kill him, we split it. It's just extra loot for us, right?
Yeah, but then we have to kill him.
Yeah.
And that's effort.
Then we have to dispose of the cars, and then we have to just...
Is that dragon still nearby? We could throw it the body.
There you go.
Well, we just cut off his legs, take the wheels, and then we have spares.
That's not a bad idea, actually. Let's do that.
Please, no. I have a business to run.
Not anymore, you don't.
Well, then.
Yes, but this is effort now.
Yeah, it's true.
We have to work? Aw.
This was great until I realized, like, yeah, we're going to have to actually do something.
There's 500 caps on the line.
Yeah.
Though I'm surprised the person from the ministry isn't really speaking up about all this, you know, child murder.
What should I say?
You should try and stop us. Or at least not condone our activities.
Right, the medic always has to be the voice of reason.
I saw a jackknife.
When they are plastering the Ministry of Peace on them, yes.
What were you saying there, Crash Cut?
No, that I saw you bribe a bunch of robots and sprite bots. I don't think stopping you is going to be an easy thing to do if I tried.
Glad we had this understanding.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got more than one knife. I should probably clean that knife. It's got robot goo.
Well, if you're not practicing proper blade maintenance, you don't deserve it, so you probably should.
What usually happens is I stab it in a person and then take their knife and stab that knife in somebody else and take their knife and so on and so forth.
So what, you've just been swapping knives? That's a complete waste.
Saves me carrying them.
This is true.
I'm pretty sure if I tried that, ponies would come.
Well, I would hope so, especially if you're like sticking a scalpel in them and hoping you're going to get another one back.
Which I have to sort of give you a slow clap to, you know. Throwing a scalpel, hoping the sharp end goes into a robot.
Sorry
if it actually went into the robot.
I'm sure there'll be someone in the comments of the YouTube video later. Scalpel can't actually do that.
Oh, someone's already done that in the actual...
Oh yeah, no, I saw.
Chat.
I'm just... For even later, I wanna end before that, too.
I left my gun in my other... Sorry.
What pants?
Oh, he wasn't going to say pants. That's why he stopped.
This is why everyone needs a duster.
So you're leaving the merchant alone, I take it.
Unfortunately. Yeah.
There was a period there where I was in doubt.
Wait, can we point him in the direction of the dragon and see if he gets eaten?
He's heading in the opposite direction, and the dragon's kind of over everybody right now.
I'm also assuming we didn't have that conversation in character in front of him.
No, I mean...
I think they wouldn't be here if we did.
Have like a 15-minute conversation about how we're going to kill this person. Turn around. Okay, we're ready to buy your... Shit, there they go.
But isn't this how normal RPGs go? You threaten the merchant, and yet they still let you buy stuff from them?
You threaten the merchant, you get a discount, you threaten him again, he runs off, then you can't just get the stuff anyway.
Yes, we're leaving the merchant alone.
Okay.
For now.
He passes by you and continues on his way north.
Alright. How many hours is
25
it?
25 minutes traveling? Pass without incident.
I'm worried about how specific that time was. Do you want to give us seconds as well while you're there?
25 and 1, 25 and 2, 25 and 3.
There's an Applejack range on a hill somewhere with a wooden sign just putting up new signs for each second that goes by. Oh, nobody kills someone. Start again.
Oddly specific.
Yes.
Paranoia intensifies.
And still nothing happens. You're still just traveling along.
So, you guys got plans to get paid?
Might buy my wife something nice.
A pillowed razor?
Nah. She doesn't appreciate my, less savory jobs. So I try not to remind her too often.
Probably a good idea.
She sounds like the person who just gave her maniacally at two bears high-fiving. No, my plan is to go to the next job, do that job, go to the next job, have a nap, and repeat.
She'd probably have more than a nap.
There's nothing better than a good nap.
Actual sleep?
I never said it was a short nap.
Sure.
What about you, Nocturne?
Probably just save it up. There's not really much to get in the wasteland.
Probably try your luck outside the mall.
True. I'll just have to see how much I have on top of what I'm getting. And I might do that.
I suppose that's something.
How about you, Crash Cat?
Me? Well, probably buy medical supplies, bring it back home. What I could do for some of the residents.
You're an actual, like, settlement doctor? Not, like, a wandering one?
I do have a place I call home.
Surprised they could do without you while you're out here.
Well, at the moment, they really can't do much with me. We're sort of out of medical supplies, and there's a bit of a nasty cold going around, put it nicely. That's pretty much put the strain on what we can do. So, you know, I see if I can raise a few caps to restock.
The, a strange rattling sound comes from inside the cart.
Can we open this?
As long as you
I'm not sure we're meant to open it.
It depends on whether you reset the lock or not.
Yeah.
Well, we opened it once.
When we wanted to look like that, we weren't in it while we weren't in it in the first place.
We can blame it on the filly.
That's yes, the reason and the merchant did it in the first place.
I don't think we can blame the merchant, but the filly definitely.
We can blame the filly for the first time, the merchant for the second. It's fine.
The whole cart itself also starts vibrating a bit and glowing blue as well.
Guys, you may want to detach yourself from that.
Doing so.
All right. Well, what does it got to roll to unlock this thing? Locked it.
Dexterity.
Okay. Oh boy.
Thanks to what seems to be the earlier tampering, the lock isn't that hard to dismantle, and you manage to spin the wheel and throw the door open. And you notice that the server racks inside are also kind of shaking and glowing blue.
Pretty sure that's not normal.
No, what was your first thought?
Okay, looking around inside, I suppose.
As you start to step inside, both the blue around the cart and the servers start to really intensify. They start vibrating so fast it looks like they're in two spots at once.
Oh dear.
Anyone close enough to grab him and pull him out?
Probably be us, because we're behind.
Should we roll?
You may want to roll might to pull him back.
Oh, fun.
Oh, jeez.
my might.
I'm not done looking.
My might is my worst score.
Oh, my might's 6, but it's whatever.
There's 500 caps on the line here.
Yeah, but if you die, then that's a problem too.
I'll jump off, unminiaturize, and then, like, can I roll might as well to help?
Yeah.
For my amazing might.
Where were these rolls before?
11.
That's where it went.
Fully unminiaturize?
I don't even bother unminiaturizing. I just jump on him, like, stop pulling his mane. Leave.
You just barely manage to pull him back from the intensely warping vehicle. before the server racks themselves emit this blinding flash of light, and then a few seconds later, the cart does as well. Just this huge, almost explosion of, not quite explosion, but this huge burst of aurora-colored energy.
Hit the goddamn dirt.
Run.
Oh, Celestia.
And it kicks off this huge dust cloud. When the dust settles, the cart and its cargo are nowhere to be found.
What the actual fuck?
I will turn to Nocturne and applaud.
I am sensing the same for all the magic. All the magic.
All that seems to be left behind is a spider.
How'd that get there?
Wait, isn't that your spider?
Yeah, but as you all saw, I took it out, so how'd it get in there?
I'm asking the same question.
I pull my blade. So, if you took it out, anything else you want to tell us?
Let's say, I took it out. I have no fucking clue what has happened.
Then why is the spider still here?
If I was to go and do anything, why would I leave the spider in there? If I was going to magically take it away, why would I leave the spider in there?
Maybe you didn't have a choice.
There's always a choice. The thing is, I admitted the thing was mine. You all saw me take it out.
Yes, we did.
You're right.
With Crash Cart as my witness, I didn't go back in.
Then show us the one you took.
Wait. Did you stick that spider under the cart?
No. If I stuck it under the cart, what is it inside? I mean, Crimson's going to pick up the thing and try and see if it will fit through the vent. Does it fit through the vent?
What vent?
Gone.
There is no cart.
I'm thinking the box is gone. My mistake.
All of it's gone.
The entire thing is gone. There's
my misinterpretation. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I will walk over and I will I'll double tap Jackknife on the side and be like, okay, this is a stressful time, but in all seriousness, what the fuck did you do?
I'm telling you, I did not put it back in there. Crimson,
where is it? My little grasshopper. I feel so lucky without him.
Yeah. Wait. I thought you had your grasshopper.
He was sitting on top. Hood ornament. He didn't vaporize, did he?
Son of a bitch.
What?
What?
I.
Can we have a word?
You fuck. I will pull my straight razor and I will just walk over to real quick, promise this won't hurt.
Wait, what?
Jump back and fly up.
I will double tap Crash Cart as well. Nocturne. Nocturne, come here.
Bud?
What?
I'm pulling out my scalpel.
I was pulling the cart. Why are we looking at me?
I will walk over and I will double tap Nocturne as well.
Nope, wing slapping you. Do not touch a lady.
I'm not going to do anything invasive. I just need to check something. It'll be real quick. Nothing's going to hurt.
And how exactly are you checking anything?
Just a hunch, you know?
Yeah, I don't trust that hunch.
I get that a lot.
Explain it first, and then maybe. The chat needs to stop.
The chat needs to keep going.
Fight, fight, fight. Kiss, kiss, kiss.
God damn it, what did I say about shipping? We had this conversation.
What is going down?
Alright, I will I'll back up and be like, well, if I'm right, you're all like the little girl was, aren't you?
What?
What?
Oh, come on. Don't tell me you haven't figured it out. She wasn't exactly on the level, and I have a feeling you guys aren't either. So what the fuck did you do to my 500 cap paycheck?
It's not okay. Just your 500 cap paycheck.
Yeah.
You know what? Sod it. Crimson's just sort of got a rock on her back in the middle of the air as she begins to glow. Zone of truth, boys. Zone of truth.
Oh, you want us to speak the truth? Okay.
You activate your zone of truth power.
Oh, God.
Jackknife, the one that says you create a beacon of white light which shines out as far as you wish up to 1,000 feet from you in all directions. All illusions within light vanish. All invisible creatures are revealed, and all things within it can be seen as they truly are despite disguise or transmutation. All creatures the white light touches, including you, are unable to speak falsehoods and are aware of that fact. The light lasts for 1 hour, though you may end this effect early if you choose, and it ends automatically if you willingly enter combat.
Yep.
You want the truth? Fine. Jackknife and Crash Card are synths.
So are you, you son of a bitch.
Well, yeah, but at least, you know, I do it well. I'm going to assume Nocturne is as well.
You cannot speak falsehoods.
Does not speak.
You can choose to just not, you can just choose to not say anything.
Well, I'm going
Wait,
to make
hang on a minute, hang on a minute, Spud. I asked something about this earlier, so if we're all synths... I asked something what would happen if
Oh yes, you did. Everyone you know it seems as though a magical glamour has lifted from all four of you and you look a bit more mechanical than you usually do. Not by a lot, but you can see sort of the seams between sort of the outer plates. From all four of you.
Oh my god.
Well, this is awkward.
I love
For
this.
The love of Luna's left hoof.
That would explain all the teleportation errors. So, wow. For me, who else had one in there?
Me.
Me.
Bart, basic atomic resonance transponder.
Who was
you
the
clever
spider?
Bastard, I approve.
To be honest, that's what the ladybug was too.
So you were the one who did that to my ladybug?
That was yours?
Yeah, oh. An ant.
I thought you saw me when I squished it.
I was very mad. I should squish you.
You saw what I did to those robots over there. I can take you. Anyway.
I'll take all of us.
But if we all took it away, we all have the same fucking objective. Now.
Do we? Because I don't know about you guys, but I'm confident enough I could probably track it with enough time and effort. And... I'm assuming you guys can too, so, I mean, if there's less of us, just saying.
I have a better idea. But first, may as well ask this now, just so we're all on the same individual level. Crash Car, did you successfully get it?
You cut out for a bit there.
No, I got the cart. That's it.
Have that. From your reaction, Razor, you didn't get it.
I just got a whole bunch of transponder errors.
As did I.
That's because I squished yours, but yes.
I put a second one in, of course.
Huh.
Yeah, I put one in too, which is the spider on the floor there. I mean, I didn't physically put it in, I wasn't lying.
Good. Where did it go?
I don't know. I don't have monitor. Which is why... Actually, is it possible to do a magical aura check on the location? That is, this one being happening anyway, so that'll cancel it out.
Well, their system's already scanning for the location, but the destination vectors got so scrambled, it might take a couple of days to figure out exactly where it landed.
2 days.
Well, that's just peachy.
In fairness, we have a destination to go to, though. Who wants to go rob a vault?
Wait, how do you know it's at a vault?
Stable.
Sorry.
Because it was told to us.
Yeah, it's stable 998.
Going to the technological center of the moor.
Wait, question for Spud.
Yes.
Do we know that Oromar is in there?
Yeah. What's
his name told us, didn't he?
Can I bring up the thing I PM'd you earlier this week?
Allow me to go through.
Which is...
What have we done?
And this is how the one shot accidentally turned into a campaign.
I'm not sure what exactly you're referring to, but
can we take Oromar?
Vault.
No, oh my god, you evil genius!
Well,
you're the vault stable 998 is going to be rather well defended.
Can we take a love cup?
All right, hands up who's totally willing to attempt to steal a cyber dragon.
Hell yeah.
I offered it. But they also know that we're coming, so it's not really defended if they know we're coming in.
Actually,
they're going to ask questions.
We all know
like,
who each other are. Why don't we just go back home and change?
Because at this point, it's probably easier to keep working as a group. I mean, people expect us to be together now.
Yes.
They also expect us to bring the cart with a server inside it.
Well, they also expect the cart. And there's quite a bit in the around us in the wasteland. So why don't we try and make a substitute cart?
Road trip!
Okay.
The thing about, you know, you haven't actually said, for the sake of those listening, what you guys are besides synth.
Oh, right. Sorry. We are all breezy synths. Well, we're basically breezies in pony mech suits, less sort of true synths, I guess.
Get in the fucking robot, Breezy.
You're all breezies from the Breezy Institute.
The Institute, yes.
Please tell me Obi was the only one who wasn't a breezy.
That might not be... Well, I'll have to ask him if that's still canon anymore, since he wasn't in this session, but...
Everyone is breezies.
But
everybody.
Were we really all breezies?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, this is beautiful.
I love it.
The idea had crossed my mind yesterday. Thought it would be hilarious, and then I just dismissed it.
It was one of those, it could have been, but I thought Spud would have enjoyed making us PvP against each other, like 1v4. More than having us all be breezies.
Like, I know it mentioned that there's probably one, but then as the campaign started, it kept getting really hard to keep track of who I thought was a breezy. I'm like, there's no way that every single one of us is a breezy.
Yes.
And then it happened. I love this. This is the best. Oh, so yeah, we're going to go steal Oromar, right?
Heck yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
The thing about stealing Oromar is that the Institute's a lot more focused on individual advancement than sort of teams. Teams at the Institute tend to be more, like, the credit tends to go more towards the team leaders. So you might, even if you try and get it together, you...
Gnosis leader!
Well, I was going to suggest...
You might still have to fight over the credit.
If we're going into
and
the
also,
technological advanced place in the moor...
There's also
Once
a lot of
dragon,
stuff in the stable.
Yeah, so we
Besides,
all theoretically come out with brand new inventions each.
Yes.
I'm totally stealing myself a love cat.
How about this? We together steal Oromar, but everyone else takes something of their own from the stable itself.
That is also assuming that you can overcome all of the defenses and the people there.
Spud, are you honestly telling me that you don't believe I, of all people, could break into this base and steal something? I'm disappointed in your lack of faith.
But we have monks
A cyber dragon is not a simple thing to steal.
Oh, and it'll be fine.
You need hardware and oh yeah.
Isn't there a dragon flying overhead?
Actually, Smarty brings up a good point. The actual body of Oromar, did we completely destroy that?
Yeah, you destroyed that. You obliterated that to release the soul that was bound to the Lich.
My idea was just Oromar as a precaution if I lost to whoever was the other Breezy. That's why I brought it up.
We may not even have to steal Oromar.
We need the USB drive.
I actually thought that Manager was going to be on the USB drive, which is why I had so many big pockets.
Yeah, I know, right? You had conceal. You had what was
yes,
it?
Yes, and the upgrade.
Yep.
That's kind of why I didn't make it a tiny thing.
If all of us did, if we didn't do it, you probably wouldn't have done it.
Don't worry, I just out of character really quickly. Don't worry, I broke this in like 2 minutes at 2 a.m. when Spud gave me my Breezy thing. It was pretty great. Because he told me my transponder counted as an object. So I'm like, cool, activate transponder, activate concealment, put it on thing 5 minutes in, done.
Oh, why didn't I do that? Shit.
Because it doesn't count as an object because I kind of talked Spud out of allowing it to be counted as an object.
Oh, you are a pain.
Because it moves around and it's kind of creature-like, so... After thinking about it for a second, I realized that ruling was broken. Well, I think now that the scenario for this session has ended, I think, and we might have room for a follow-up, I think that's where we'll call it for tonight. But, do we just want to make this a whole, like, DLC campaign for...
Fuck yes!
Yeah.
Alright, well... How about we hash out scheduling if we end up continuing this, which might happen.
Okay.
But for now we sign off. We
don't have a thing though.
We don't actually have a thing for the spot shots.
We are the tale of four Breezy stealing a stable AI. Let's go.
This has been the September 2016. SpudShot, the one-shot campaign. If you're a pledge to my Patreon, patreon.com/newbiespud, at least $1, you can apply for next month's SpudShot. If you are above the $5 level, you will be keep your eye on the Patreon because there will be a post immediately sharing the raw audio file from this, the raw unedited file. And then for everybody else, it'll be coming out Thursday, I think. But for now, that's our session tonight. Oh, boy.
Oy vey.
I regret nothing.
This is the best.
You know,
I love that I thought
of
that.
That's about how I wanted it to turn out. Maybe a bit more actual open PvP, but you know what? This is fine, too. And I guess we'll see about continuing this, because apparently it's just... It's just a little too awesome.
One shots don't are never a thing with you, Spud. It's always a campaign or nothing.
I'm not gonna try and do like 60 sessions of this. No, this will this will have a goddamn ending.
I would hope so.
Anyway, well, thank you, Avis Echo, Chrono Zephyr, Digo Dragon, and Zen Karn for playing very much. Thanks for making this first outing really fun.
You're welcome.
Do our best.
Thanks for letting us play.
Yeah, thanks for hosting.
And to everyone else, have a good day, night, whatever. See you next time.